Morning, dear students. I am Amrita, your chemistry lecturer. I think in the previous session we already learned few concepts which is related to our photochemistry, that is definition of photochemistry, fluorescence, phosphorescence, and the differences between the photochemical and thermochemical reaction. So today in this session we will discuss laws of photochemistry. So before going to discuss about the laws of photochemistry, I request all the students to take pen and paper, so it will helpful for noting important concept, because today concept is full based on mathematical related concept. So let us move on to our topic, that is laws of photochemistry. So here the law of absorption of light says that when a monochromatic light, that means here observe the word monochromatic light. Mono means single. So monochromatic light means the light consists of a single wavelength is known as monochromatic light. So when this kind of monochromatic light is passed through a pure homogeneous medium, it absorbs some amount of light. Because of this absorption, there is a decrease in the intensity of a light takes place. Okay. So next we will see the Lambert's law. So the statement of Lambert's law is given like this. When a monochromatic light is passed through the pure homogeneous medium, the decrease in the intensity of the light with the thickness of the absorbing medium at any point is proportional to the intensity of the incident light. This is a statement of Lambert's law. So I will explain the statement now. That means monochromatic light, that means the light consists of a single wavelength. Okay, so when this monochromatic light is passed through a pure homogeneous medium, it will affect on a intensity of the light, that means it decreases the intensity of the light. So decrease in the intensity of a light is given as minus dI with the thickness, that is dx, of the absorbing medium at any point is proportional to the intensity of the incident light. This is a statement of Lambert's law. So let us move on to the explanation of Lambert's law. So in the picture you will observe there is a homogeneous medium. Okay, if a light is incident on a homogeneous medium, what happens means it travels to a certain distance. So that distance is given as x, and it absorbs some amount of light, so it is given as I. So I absorbed is given as I naught minus I. This is the first part. Okay, in the second part you will observe there is a decrease in the intensity of the light, so it is given as minus dI with the thickness of the absorbing medium, so it is represented as dx. At any point is proportional to the intensity of the incident light, that is it is given as I. So here the Lambert's law explanation is given like this. That means when a monochromatic light is incident on a homogeneous medium, it is decreases the thickness of the absorbing medium, it decreases the intensity of the light with the thickness of the absorbing medium at any point is proportional to the intensity of the incident light. So this is the explanation of Lambert's law. So mathematically the Lambert's law is given like this. That means minus dI divided by dx is proportional to I. Here the minus dI represent the decrease in the intensity of the incident light with the thickness dx is proportional to the I, that is intensity of the incident light. This is called as equation 1. So on removing this proportionality constant, you will get a new equation. So it is written as minus dI divided by dx is equal to ki. So this is called as equation 1. Okay. So here minus dI represent the there is a small decrease in the intensity of the light, and here the dx will tells that thickness of the absorbing medium, and I represent the intensity of the incident light. Okay, Here, the K, that means the proportionality K, is called as absorption coefficient. Okay. Again, observe this equation. Minus di divided by dx is equal to K into I. Okay. This is called as equation 2. If you rearrange this equation 2, you will get a new equation, that is minus di divided by I is equal to minus k into dx. Okay. Next, here on integrating this equation 1, if you integrate equation 1 by considering the limits value such as x is equal to 0 and I is equal to I naught, and this is the case 1, and the in case 2 you have to put x value, that as x is equal to x and I is equal to I, we get log I divided by I naught is equal to minus kx. This is the equation 2. How do you get this equation 2? Means on integrating equation 1 with the limits value, that is x is equal to 0 and I is equal to I naught in case 1, and in case 2 x is equal to x and I is equal to I, then you will get a new equation, that is equation 2. It is given like this: log I by I naught is equal to minus kx. On simplifying equation 2, you will get I by I naught is equal to e to the power of minus kx. Okay. Then I is equal to I naught e to the power of minus kx. So this is a rearranging. On rearranging this equation, you will get I is equal to I naught e to the power of minus kx. So this is very important. This is called as equation star. Okay. Next, observe this one. The difference between I naught and I gives the intensity of a light absorbed. So intensity of the light absorbed is given by I absorbed is equal to I naught minus I. Okay. We already have the value of I, that means I value is given as I is equal to I naught into e to the power of minus kx. This value you have to substitute in this equation, then I absorbed will becomes like this, that means I absorbed is equal to I naught minus I naught into e to the power of minus kx. Okay, so consider this equation, that is log I by I naught is equal to minus kx. So if you rearranging this equation, you will get 2.303 log I divided by I naught is equal to minus kx. So if you rearrange this equation, log I by I naught will comes in LHS side. So it is given as log I by I naught is equal to minus k divided by 2.303 into x. Okay, so here log I by I naught is equal to minus k dash x. This is called as equation 3. Here the k dash will represent the k dash value is given as, that means k dash is equal to k divided by 2.303. okay, so here equation 3 becomes I by I naught is equal to 10 to the power of minus k1x, or else I is equal to I naught into 10 to the power of k1x. So here k1 is equal to k divided by 2.303 is called as extinction coefficient of the substance. That means k1 is represent the extinction coefficient of the substance. So this is the derivation of Lambert's law. So this is a mathematical representation of Lambert's law. So this is very important. So you have to learn this law by deriving the equation 1 or 2 times. So thanks for watching. If you have any doubt, in the previous in the next session we will discuss few concepts. Thanks for watching.